My name is Kevin Grant. I'm the co-founder and chief content officer at the Ground Truth Project. It's a nonprofit media organization that supports the next generation of journalists. We have created two signature programs called Report for America and Report for the World. And both of those initiatives create new local reporting positions in communities around the world. And many of those reporting positions focus specifically on economic equity in different ways. And this is such an incredibly difficult question, I think, because it's deceptively simple. An equitable economy to me is one in which every participant in that economy has at least the opportunity to have success, to bring in income and other resources that will allow themselves, their family, and perhaps their larger community to have healthy lives. So, you know, a lot of our reporters cover housing, development, public services, healthcare, education. And really, again and again, their journalism demonstrates sort of deep structural inequality in every aspect of our society. They are able to, through that journalism, actually shine a spotlight on a number of these inequalities, and sometimes are actually able to bring about change, or are able to help shift policy or change a budget, or perhaps push out a leader who is, you know, doing something corrupt or promoting inequality in some way. To me, communication is actually at the heart. And what we're seeing, especially in this sort of social media age, when misinformation is competing with high quality information at every turn, it's really easy for people to be distracted from the social divisions, from the structures, the sort of social structures, the economic structures that are marginalizing and harming many of us. So I think that's part of it too. It's acknowledging the situation that many of us are in, at least those of us who are not part of the super rich, and then also doing everything we can to sort of transcend the misinformation that can be so distracting. Local journalism plays this incredible sort of galvanizing force in communities. And so, you know, I personally am dedicated to supporting that local journalism in American communities and in communities all over the world. For myself, it's about sort of strengthening the power of the press, demonstrating the way that actually local journalism, in holding leaders to account, can create a more equitable, more just economy, and a more just society. This sort of dedication to that kind of work, it really sort of shows returns very quickly, in the sense that we see the way in which different members of the community engage with the journalism, the way that they can create sort of campaigns or different ways of pushing back against inequality or an injustice, you know, with one another. And we also see the way that solutions journalism can be an uplifting force in different communities. Solutions journalism is I think, one of the strongest tools in the toolkit when it comes to the media, when it comes to sort of information sharing in communities. So solutions journalism is sort of championed by an organization called the Solutions Journalism Network. They really, at this point, are working all over the world. They have a really fantastic framework for how reporters and editors anywhere can essentially take steps, not just to diagnose problems, but really to focus on the response to those problems. What they have found is that members of the public really respond a whole lot better to solutions journalism than they do to regular journalism. It gives people hope. It gives them often sort of a roadmap or a blueprint for a solution that may have worked somewhere else and that they might implement in their own community.